Hello and welcome. In this video, we're going to be adjusting the ride height. So to do that, we're going to adjust the coilovers and lower them a bit. So you can see here, we've got a pretty big gap between the tire and the wheel arch. I've measured a point from right here, this ring going around, to the wheel arch, and that's 4.7 inches. So we're probably going to drop it an inch and a half or about 2 inches and bring that down some. So the first thing we need to do is get the car up on jack stands and remove the tires. Okay, so once I've got the wheel off and the car jacked up, we can go ahead and adjust the coilover. So it's actually pretty simple. What I did first is I measured the distance from the bottom of this ring here to the bottom of this ring here, and that was 2.8. So if I want to lower the car another 2 inches, I just got to make sure that that gap from there to there, instead of 2.8, is down 2.8, and so then it'll be 2 inches lower to the ground. Okay, so in order to actually lower the car, it's pretty simple. You're just going to be messing with these two rings right here. So you're going to be using a spanner wrench, which looks like this. And if you want to lower the car, what you're going to do is you're going to turn this upper ring here to the left, so like this. And then if you want to lower the car, or raise the car, rather, you're going to use this second ring here and turn that to the right. So you'll be turning that like that, and that would raise the car up. So since we want to lower it, we're going to be turning this upper ring here to the left. And periodically you're going to want to measure the distance between here and here, and check what your gap is so that you make sure you don't overshoot what you want to get, and you meet your target. So once you measure and you get the height to where you want to tighten down this lower ring nut, and you can use the spanner wrench and get it on there and then tighten that pretty good so that doesn't move at all. And then you can put your wheel back on and lower your car. So once you drop the car down, you can measure and see what how much you've actually dropped it. So I ended up dropping it at about 2.5 inches. Which was a little more than I wanted to, but I can go ahead and adjust that later if I want. So after lowering your car, it's going to alter your wheel's alignment, so you're going to want to make sure you go ahead and get a wheel alignment after lowering or raising your vehicle. So thanks for watching. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below.